Hi students, how are you? I hope you are doing well in the VAT examinations. I am Shiva, Faculty of Physics. Today I am here in order to discuss the concept of electric field due to the dipole on the equatorial point for 8th standard students. So here you are seeing one dipole, so labeled as with charges plus Q minus Q. Both are separated by the distance 2L. This is perpendicular bisector of this dipole. Something you are seeing now, OP. OP indicates perpendicular bisector. Otherwise, you can say with this name, equatorial line. Equatorial line or perpendicular bisector. On that equatorial line or perpendicular bisector, you are seeing some point P. At that point P, now you need to calculate the electric field. That is our topic. So first of all, here you can label the direction of the electric field due to these two charges. This is plus Q, this is minus Q. Due to this plus Q, the direction of the electric field at point P you are seeing in this direction. How you can decide the direction is like this. Suppose you can place plus 1 coulomb charge here. You can place plus 1 coulomb charge here. What is the direction of the force now that plus 1 coulomb experiences due to this plus Q? That is only direction of the electric field. In the same manner, this plus 1 coulomb experiences attractive force towards this minus Q. That's why this is the direction of the electric field. Since plus Q or minus Q, both are lying at same distance. Now, that is square root of L square plus R square. That's why the electric field is also same at this point P due to plus Q and minus Q. In terms of magnitude, that can be calculated according to the formula what we discussed in the previous video. This formula E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Na? In this formula Q, that is either plus Q or minus Q, magnitude R indicates this is square root of L square plus R square. Since Q, R square both are same, automatically electric field magnitude also same. That's why we are labeled this electric field magnitude in the diagram also same. Now come to the point. So here, suppose I am assuming this is angle is theta. So this angle also theta. If this is the angle theta, this is also angle theta. While vertically opposite angles are congruent, that's why. So suppose this is E. What is the component of E in this direction? That is E cos theta. Okay. Similarly, what is the component of E in this direction? This is also E cos theta. So similarly, what is the component of this E in this direction? We can label again E cos theta. Here already we wrote E cos theta. Now we can label this one E sin theta. So component of E in this direction E sin theta. Similarly, the component of E in this direction, it will become one more E sin theta. Na? So E sin theta. So totally here you are seeing now, this E cos theta gets cancelled. Why? E cos theta having same magnitude, this E cos theta also same magnitude. Since these two are vectors directed in opposite direction at point P having same magnitude, that's why this E cos theta, both are gets cancelled. That is, vector addition will become 0 for these two components. Now, just you are seeing here clearly, only these two components are adding. Now, the resultant field also you can see in what direction? In this direction. Therefore, here what we can write? At point P, lying on where? On this equatorial line, what we can write? E net is equal to this one, E sin theta plus E sin theta. So E sin theta plus E sin theta will become 2E sin theta. 2E sin theta. Now observe carefully, what is E? So in order to calculate that E, we can use this formula. Na? Already in the last video that we have used, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R square. Again, I am using this formula here. After using this formula, what we can write for E? So 2 into 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q indicates source charge magnitude, either source charge, either plus q or minus q. Plus q or minus q magnitude there, simply what we can write, q divided by r square. R square nothing but the distance of the point P from either source charge. Clearly we are seeing that from O to point P, what is the distance? R distance. And this distance you are clearly seeing as L, total distance to L. Na? So since this is the perpendicular bisector from the center of the dipole to either charge, you are seeing that length now L. That's why here what we can say, this is square root of L square plus R square. Now this one again whole square. Na? Now what we can write, square root of L square plus R square whole square into sine theta. Okay, so again we will write as 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2q divided by L square plus R square. What is sine theta from this diagram? Sine theta clearly works. You know, you can use either this triangle or this triangle. Suppose I am using this triangle. What is sine theta? Here sine theta is equal to opposite side to theta. Opposite side to theta is L. Hypotenuse is this one. So what is this length? This length also the same as that of this one. Na? That's why this one answers square root of L square plus R square only. Now what we can write here? Sin theta is equal to opposite side to theta is L divided by hypotenuse. Now you are seeing as square root of L square plus R square. Now substitute this value here. L by square root of L square plus R square. Okay. Now do some simple algebraic calculation here. What we can write now, E net. So E net is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q into 2L divided by L square plus R square whole power 3 by 2. Okay, so this is the expression for the electric field we can use. Whatever may be the value of R, okay? So if you want to express this term in terms of P, so how we can write again? E net is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R square plus L square whole power 3 by 2, okay? So both of these expressions, you are allowed to calculate the electric field due to the dipole at any equatorial point that lies at distance r. Suppose if you are taking short dipole, so what do you mean by short dipole? Suppose I am taking that condition for r, okay? So for r is greater than L. R is greater than L means this point is lying at long distance. At that time the dipole looks like what type of dipole? Short dipole. At that time what we can write? For R greater than L, this expression R square plus L square whole power 3 by 2 approximately equivalent to R cube. Okay, so now by using this substitution, this expression again we can rewrite as E net is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into P by R cube. Okay, so this is the expression for the electric field due to the dipole whenever your point of calculation lies at large distances, otherwise the dipole is short but the point of calculation lying on what? Equatorial. In the previous video we got this expression. This expression gives the calculation of the electric field on the axial point. This one now gives the electric field due to the dipole on equatorial point. Now clearly we are seeing one relation. Now what is relation? Suppose even here I am saying as electric field due to the dipole on axial point, AB represents axial point. Similarly E2 there I am writing as electric field on the equatorial point. Now how you can relate? So E1 is equal to 2 times to the E2 na. Okay, so E1 is equal to, this is I am saying even, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi by r cube, electric field on the axial point of the dipole I am saying as even. Okay, so this is the result what we have obtained. E net is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into p by r cube. This is I am saying as E2. So how you can relate E1 with E2? So E1 is equal to, simply we can write as 2 times to the E2. Suppose in the examination the E1 given or E2 given, you can calculate either value with the help of this equation. Suppose here one more important point. What is the direction of the resultant field here? Resultant field direction you are seeing in this direction, this is E net bar. So what is the direction of the electric dipole moment you are seeing here? This is the direction of the electric dipole moment. Electric dipole moment here directed towards left. Electric field here directed towards right. Nothing but direction of the electric field is exactly opposite to the direction of the electric dipole moment. Means if you want to write down the vector expression here, how we can write? So E net bar is equal to minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into p bar by r cube. That's all. So this is the vector equation. So this vector equation suggests what for us? The direction of the electric field is opposite to the direction of the electric dipole moment. This is also one of the important observation. In the case of calculation of the electric field on the axial point, we got the direction of the electric field is same as the direction of the P bar. But here you are seeing the direction of the electric field is opposite to the direction of the P bar. So this is the calculation of the electric field due to the dipole on what point? On equatorial point. I hope all of you understood this lecture well. In the next session, we will meet with one more new concept. Thank you for watching.